I would like to invite Dr. Ashok to deliver his welcome address speech.
Assalamu alaikum. Adab. Respected Pro Vice Chancellor Professor Shakil Ahmed, Dean, Professor, Conference Chair, respected Professor Abdul Wahid, Conference Convener, respected Dr. Pradeep Kumar, Head of the Department of the Computer Science and IT, and distinguished delegates and participants. It is indeed a great honor for me to be a part of this valedictory section of the National Conference. It is a matter of great prestige to me to address this august gathering on the valedictory session. It is a National Conference on Emerging Trends and Issues in Information Communication Technology, and we have the participants, I'm told, coming from all over the country, as far as the Jammu Kashmir down to the south, and it has attracted the participants. And I'm also told that at a very short notice, more than 100 papers have been submitted. 74 papers have been discussed in the technical sessions. And excellent, in 2 days period, and attracted a huge talent from the country. I'm very happy to know that the conference has gone on very successfully, and to preside over this in the valedictory section is indeed a great honor for me. And I'm also the in-charge Vice Chancellor of Rajiv Gandhi University Knowledge Technology. It's also called IIIT in the Basar of the Nirmal district of Telangana, and it's about 200 kilometers from here, and it's in relocated rural area. We too have seven disciplines there, seven including computer science, civil, mechanical, and electronics, and the chemical technology, and so on. So we have over 7,000 students. It's a township, a residential township we have. So within that, there are the hostels. They come from, they are admitted from 10th class onwards. They are taken, and it's a six-year integrated program. So I am also very much happy to note that the National Conference has chosen this topic, Emerging Trends and Issues in ICT. And indeed, it's a great pleasure to deliver my valedictory address on this occasion. At the outset, I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me to come here and deliver the valedictory session. I am attracted by this huge, sprawling campus, excellent infrastructure that you have. And I'm very proud to be here in the Maulana Azad National Urdu University. It is indeed a great honor. I also request I already requested Mr. Pradeep and also Mr. Professor Abdul Wahid, both of them, to come and visit my lecturer, my university, and deliver the lecture, and let my students get the benefit of the expertise and wisdom of these eminent personalities. And we can think of signing even MOU, having an MOU so that students come here and we also go there. And even the professors of both the university can exchange talks and also get to know each other and also keep up with the recent trends in all the subjects. The topic that today, the national emerging trends and issues in information technology and communication is indeed has become a very, very critical, very important one. And I appreciate and thank the organizers for choosing such a relevant contemporary topic. Everybody knows what is the ICT, and everybody is enjoying the benefits, and from the comfort of home to travel and working in the workplace, wherever they go, we are almost surrounded by information communication technology. It has become a necessary part of our life. In fact, just like the pure oxygen that we can't survive without oxygen, maybe we can't live without ICT. And ICT is all over the place, and yet it is important for us to know what are these recent trends and how they also impact our lives. While ICT gives comfort, benefit, excellent technology, and makes the life simpler, easier, comfortable, yet also poses some of the issues. ethical, social and legal issues. So I think we should take stock of all of this. The key trends that are emerging these days, today in the ICT are, we have anytime, anywhere, any device access to communications, content, commerce and application. For example, consumer cloud service is a concept involving the storage of various electronic in the cloud and for the benefit of time, anytime, anywhere, any device access. Now the concept is that one would not be limited to things not being able to listen to their music because it is stored on laptop only and not accessible when wanted on the go. So this is such a wonderful facility. Increased emphasis on non-human communication. Now this is very, very important in the recent trends that we notice. With the worldwide carrier reaching saturation of human users, these network operators are looking for new ways to generate revenue and enhance profitability. So at the same time, miniaturization is reaching the point in which embedded computing can be virtually ubiquitous. And with the advent of IP version and the attendant huge increase in IP addresses, virtually everything can be placed, labeled. All of this adds to translate into world into which objects, devices, equipment and other assets are communicating, transacting, signaling. And arguably, this market will also overtake human communications rapidly, as there are vastly more objects in the world than humans. They can communicate much faster, much more frequently, and for many reasons better than humans. The convergence and integration of many things, a lot of integration is taking place. If you look at many things are converging, including everything from networks, services, entire business models. One key example that is particularly poignant for enterprise is the convergence of M2M and IoT, Internet of Things, social and big data in many enterprises. Discrete information systems that were developed over time for specific functions in an uncoordinated fashion have traditionally now hampered high-level decision-making. Therefore, when internal systems are organized in a silo fashion, top management typically struggles to spot correlations and among individual department that could indicate areas for cross-departmental divisional improvements. Historically, discrete data collection systems fail to present big data. Therefore, it is the time for convergence and integration of many things. This is also one of the serious recent trends. Open networks, open interfaces, and many applications. While a large part of the material is yet to understand their technological and strategic significance, the telco network application program interface plays a critical part in carrier networks as a secondary stream of revenue. So because of this trends, many developments are anticipated. Artificial intelligence is becoming a part of everything. There is Internet of Things, and now artificial intelligence is becoming a part of everything, getting integrated into everything from machine learning, predictive analytics, security software, intelligent agents, and more. And within the artificial intelligence, we have machine learning, deep learning, apart from other than robotics and data science. So it is going to revolutionize our life and also raise many social, ethical, legal issues. Are we going to create some Frankenstein monster who goes out of control and may even try to cause damage to the scientist who created it, the creator himself? So we should look at some of these issues, legal, ethical, social issues, because the current topic says there is a trends and issues in the ICT. So data is a central part of all corporate planning. The so-called data economy is here to stay. So everything from data analytics, big data, business intelligence, discovery and visualization of data, ICT companies of all types and enterprises are learning that data is one of their most valuable assets, even tools to realize optimal benefits. Now, cloud computing is moving beyond IT. This is a recent trend. And once integrated primarily to IoT, IT personnel tasks with reducing costs, cloud computing is becoming a strategic differentiator, enabling companies to move flexibly, manage operations, create and maintain new products and services. It is also continuing to expand beyond more pure computing to include communications, applications, contents and commerce across a diverse number of industry verticals. The Internet of Things, or IoT, or IoE, is becoming more than just a buzzword. As meaningful problems find solution, with IoT, it becomes clearer that it is not just technology chasing a need. IoT will become part of the global lexicon of indispensable things, just like smartphones and the internet itself. So it will be universal everywhere, the IoT. Broadband, particularly wireless, is enabling key technology areas. This is also one of the important trends. So it is currently the worldwide recognized standard for high-speed wireless data, that is LITE. And these applications will cause vast amount of data to come into being, which will drive the need for more expansion in the data economy. The Skillsoft Analyst Perspectives report entitled ICT Infrastructure Platform, Software and Services, Trend Analysis, Comprehensive Analysis, also include the big data, cloud computing, Internet of Things, and also include 5G. The 5G is going to be also become a great revolution in the information technology. And edge computing and NFV DevOps and advanced applications such as VD, RTC, and all energy emerging low latency dependent services such as haptic internet, augmented reality, virtual reality are also going to take the center stage. Now the cloud computing is very useful, makes maintenance of software, hardware easier, installation is not required on each. So there are many benefits of it reduces the IT infrastructure cost and promotes the concept of visualization and makes maintenance of software much easier. And computing are also some of the issues concerning cloud computing are privacy, compliance, security, legal issues, abuse, IT, governance, that is regulation. So this needs to be looked into. While we appreciate the benefits are immense, and the common man would definitely derive immense benefit from the application of professional to common man, but it raises the issues of privacy and compliance, security, legal, and also misuse or abuse, and IT governance. So this need to be addressed. Similarly, the mobile phones application and mobile app has become a success since introduction. These are designed to run on smartphone, tablets, and other mobile services. But some of the mobile apps are available free, whereas some are involved download cost. The revenue collected is shared between application distributor, app developer. So this is one of the mobile application has become a very common phenomena. And you know, today, for every service, we have a mobile application. For every service, we need a mobile application to be downloaded and has to be done. For example, we have in the intermediate education, we have introduced exam center locator. And in that, whenever when the student is allotted a new center, he doesn't know where it is. He doesn't know where it is located. Already he is having examination tension. So exam begins from 9 to 12. So he need not bother. He just can enter the hall ticket number on that mobile app after downloading it. And very soon the picture of the allotted center exam center will unfold. And also it will show a navigation map. And it will tell the student that you are 28 minutes away from center and that this is the shortest route you can take. So that way there are many exam centers with the same name, some X name or Y name. So if a student lands in a wrong place, he can never reach the center in time. So that's why we have arrived. So the mobile applications like that exam center locator for 10 lakh students we have devised across the state. And because exam centers are new, at least for the first day or second day, and the subject wise also. So if you do not give the mobile applicator, there will be a lot of confusion and they will not be able to reach in time. And we are saying no one should reach the examination center after commencement of the examination. Not even 1 minute late is allowed to prevent high-tech copying. So these are the very, very important measures. So mobile applications, today we have put all our intermediate services online, everything, about 22 services online. Downloading the mobile application, they can pay the fee and can ask for any certificate, and the digital copy will be sent to them on the mobile. And if he's in either Adilabad or Khammam, 300 kilometers away, he can simply take that and connect it to the printer and take the digital certificate. And he can reduce the cost, time, and efficiency, and can get the time this certificate without having to travel much distance and get it inconvenience. So these are some of the mobile applications are doing it. So we are using mobile application for many things, to give ease. Similarly, if you look at water services or electricity or municipal corporation, everybody is extensively using this mobile application. In fact, the she team is about our Telangana government have launched protection to women, and so the she team also have provided with a mobile software, and it can be downloaded, and it gives immense protection to the women, and they can prevent themselves falling into any dangerous situation and can alert their nears and dears. In fact, some of them have the numbers of the father, brother or sister or their close friends. So once they are in trouble, they can just give a snap, just give a signal, and then that reaches to any of these four people or all of these four people. They can know that there is some problem and can immediately alert the police, and that way they can save their nears and dears, particularly the women protection. So the state government has come out with Telangana government has come out with a very innovative technology as is she teams. This is also, so we are using mobile applications in our day-to-day life, and from a student to the senior citizen, everybody came. Now everything is online. Everything is online. The people need not come to any place. The people need not visit any office. They simply can download. Today we are giving affiliations to our college online. So from the comfort of his college or home, he can apply for his application for affiliation. And within if he submits all the documentation, again we download the mobile app, take the pictures of the college, inspect it, and put it on the internet, online, and then we examine and give certificate. So we give a SMS to the college owner, your application has been processed and affiliation is being forwarded to you. Further, you will get SMS, then you can download the certificate of affiliation sitting from the comfort of home or college. Earlier there were stories, the people were going around the offices, meeting so many people, running from pillar to post, charges of corruption, bribery, middlemen, all that have softly encouraged. Only mobile application, just one click away, you get all the services today. So this is how the mobile applications have really made our life so much comfortable, so much good. And this is one emerging trend, and it is being awarded. We are using IT as a platform for increasing our efficiency in our governance administration. Today, every department in the Telangana government has mobile application and online information, online services, so that students are, so that the consumer, the applicant is not put to any trouble, and he can get the services very effectively, speedily, in a time-bound manner, and get all the counseling and also helpline desk information by phone. So the mobile applications are indeed a part of improving our governance and administration. And we are adopting in our day-to-day life, and many more are yet to come. And we are going to devise many of such mobile applications. So this is a recent trend, and it is an emerging trend. It is integrated into our administration system. Today, we call, for example, my files, they come on what is called as e-office. So no delay, no charges of corruption. People coming and meeting and saying, my pension file is with you, kindly do something, nothing. The petitioner need not contact the clerk or anything. If he has any problem, he can call up HOD and say, sir, my application. And also, because it's online, the message goes to him. Sir, you have submitted the application, but you don't have this. Please forward the document. Only that they have to do. And so, the message, it will be processed in 15 minutes, 15 days or 10 days, as per the citizen charter. So this way, we are using e-office, e-governance. Now, tenders. If you look at tenders, we are doing what is called e-commerce, e-procurement. So it is on the web. Anybody can apply, and you can upload the documents which are required as per the tender document and participate. Earlier, supposing there used to be a tender, so the people used to come from different places, meet there, and there were instances where people from outside were kidnapped, not allowed, are diverted not to file the tender. There is a physical interference, physical abuse, charges of diverting them, and so on. And they are forming ring or cartel. Now everything is on online and e-procurement. So this has made life really simple. Anybody with offering services and fully eligible and qualified and can give his technical documents in support of his claim, he will get the tender. And you all also get the technical evaluation will be done. So these are some of the bits. They have transformed their lives, and it is not as if It is not a theory anymore. It is making the citizen life comfortable. And every type, eliminating corruption, red tapism, increasing the efficiency, speedy disposal of cases, and excellent good governance is being facilitated by IT. This is a wonderful thing. And it is going to be a boon for many of us in the administration. That is some of the mobile application. Now, in other areas like user interfaces, the interface has undergone a revolution with the introduction of touch screen. Touch screen, as a result, with the visualization icon you touch, even illiterate can become interactive with the computer. And even today, any person who is not even literate also can easily operate, and it is a user-friendly interface that we have provided. So ever since the touch screen, it has revolutionized the concept of thing. Today, suddenly we realize that our lives not only made simple, the cell phone has become indispensable part of our life. And all of us forget the phone numbers of our near and dear also. We look for them in our mobile and then click. So this is the comfort that it is offering for every citizen in the society. Now analytics, the field of analytics has grown many folds in recent years. Analytics is a process which helps in discovering the information patterns and data. Now the field of analytics is a combination of statistics, computer programming and operation research. Very good combination. And the field of analytics has grown in the field of data analytics, predictive analytics and social analytics. Again, these have immense implication to the society. So data analytics is used to support decision making process. And it converts raw data into meaningful information. So decision making needs inputs, information. And again, this is useful in almost not only in corporate sector, but in the government, both the state governments, public government, and also the corporate sector. And predictive analytics is to predict future events based on current and historical information, like weather, like trends in the commerce, business, stock market. All this can be done by predictive analytics. And social analytics is used to companies to understand and accommodate customer needs. So these are some of the things. Information technology has been great advancement and changes in the last decade. And the emerging trend, it can be concerned. Its influence on businesses is growing, today growing, and helping companies to serve consumers better. So the social media analytics is very, very interesting. It is, they dig deep into the database of the individuals and try to find out what are their hobbies, what are their needs, what are the requirements, what do they do, how do they spend their day. Then try to model their products, customize the product as per the needs of the many of those customers. So delving deep into the data and trying to use those inputs to promote their products. So it is indeed, commerce is looking up better and doing better because of this predictive analytics. So there's a lot of revolution. There's a great impact on the internet revolution on the business. Advancement in communication and ICT has further strengthened the role of internet in business. The internet is widely used in organizations for marketing and promotion of products and services. So internet's Porter 5 force model is a framework for industry analysis, business analysis development, and also study competition. Now the five forces of the model are the threat from upcoming and future competition, threat from existing. So there is a threat of new entrants, there is a threat of new substitute, and a bargaining power of customers and bargaining power of suppliers. These are some of the five forces. Fifth force is threat of competition. So internet and the very business is connected and also very much integrated. Communication technology, in fact, has changed the dimensions of the business. And today, it is combined with internet has given a new dimension to connectivity and dispensation of information and dissemination of information. Employees are in constant touch through email, instant messaging, office internet, and so on. So it has brought a networking and connectivity, the social networking, very meaningful, effective. Collaboration, the internet has facilitated collaboration among employees of organization and blurring the geographical boundaries and making the geographical boundaries non-existent and meaningless. Business transaction, the internet has anticipated the culture of online business, e-commerce. In recent years, many players have opened shops through e-commerce. And also internet banking payment gateways are part of normal supply chain transaction. Today we are talking about paperless society, and we know that banking, everything on online banking and lesser cash transaction, more on online payment. Now this has been made possible through internet, and the business transaction has taken a new leap forward. It has probably been at a different level in the technological revolution today, and the underlying this is the internet that is facilitating this kind of e-commerce and also online banking, online payment. The work flexibility, because of internet, it has enabled workers to log in from anywhere location and any time. So anywhere remote location, you can work from the comfort of the house by logging in. This work flexibility is given because of internet. So you can be connected to your workplace from your home or wherever you are traveling, and can address your people and pass on instruction. There are web-based applications. The internet has facilitated the development of concept like cloud computing, and which has enabled the process and storing of data in the large proportion. Now that internet has made a big impact on in the very way the business gets conducted, in both the positive as well as negative way. Internet has made many business obsolete. Example like post office, it has destroyed the post office, because email came, Instagram, everything came. Now whenever somebody comes before me and say, I'm working in postal office, then I say, oh, do you have postal office? Does it exist now? What do they do? Abhi inka kya kaam hai? So then they say, no sir, we are doing this. So still in the rural area, in some places, we are sending our manuscripts, question paper through rural, this postal services. But by and large, biggest sufferer is postal communication. And it has also online security issues like hacking, identity theft are a constant threat to internet users. So now you know that there are many cloning, hacking, all these things. A lot of people get messages, your 30,000 has been just drawn, and you don't even know. Suddenly you realize, so somebody else is doing shopping for you somewhere. Then we realize, so this is the negative effect of this thing. So launching a police crime, cyber warfare, all these are going on. So that's why for hacking, we have come out with what is called ethical hacking. So to counter that, and also counter to that ethical hacking, is to have strong password and aspects of security, cyber security. So while internet is providing so much comfort and also revolution in our day-to-day life, it has its own problems. People are not feeling secure to have their money in the bank, and anytime they're getting messages, that is becoming a big threat. And people are worried about this. Time to time, somebody, hacking, getting into their information, trying to take their private information, and so on. But we need to have checks and guardrails for those. While the trends are very much welcome, but it needs to, security issues need to be addressed. And the 7S framework, internal technology framework, 7S framework, is yet another by McKinsey, is one of the ways through which analysis can be done to determine the efficiency of organization in meeting strategic objectives. What are those 7S? There are strategy, structure, systems, staff, style, and skills, shared values. So usage of framework. The basis of framework is that for organization to meet its objective, it is essential all the 7 elements are in sync, in synchrony, and mutually balancing. Now, model is used to identify which out of 7 frames need to be balanced as to align with the change in organization. 7S framework is helpful in identifying the pain points which are creating a hurdle in organization growth. So it's a very useful tool in industry, technology, governance, and corporate sector. For business effectivity, we have innovation opportunities coming through. Development and information system has brought opportunities, but also threats. But to identify opportunity and implement, organization needs to develop strategies. The most common practice with regard to information system is automation. Now the automation has made the system very, very effective, and business also more effective, efficiency has increased, and they are able to get more customer service done effectively. Systems and customer design. So the customer design, customization of a product has been made possible because of the use of the internet, ICT communication system. And organizational productivity has been also on the increase because of this. And workers' productivity. In fact, there is a fear among the workers that IT may one day put them out of the jobs, or they may have to go for a large scale retrenchment. Now, this is one of the concerns. When I've introduced in my office, in the board, online services, about 50 people were required earlier. Now the 50 people are not required. They have to put for other jobs. So they came and told me, sir, eventually you will do the online, and will you send all of us home? Humko ghar bhija denge kya? Then he said, no, it's not like that. Manual interaction has to be there. So we will identify the jobs, responsibility which are ideal for you. So don't be afraid of getting jobless. We will definitely accommodate your job. So we are only making it more effective and efficient. So there's a large scale apprehension among the workers. This is again one threat coming out of the technology of this system, information system. And it will add a value add for the organization. We can make our services effective and better. The IoT, that is Internet of Things, indeed is a very, very revolutionary thing. And for a long time, this has come to stay, and now will impact our life very meaningful ways, in many ways. Now the key trends are, the more important things that we need to address is, how do we overcome some of the problems of the, that are, well, the benefits are derived. So the IT talks about some of this application part, and but it also brings out with it many issues that are have to be addressed. And if you look at health side, it has really brought a lot of revolution and made the diagnostic component very effective. So today, computers in medicine play an important role. For example, a scanner takes a series of pictures of the body by means of computerized axial tomography, CAT scanning, and MRI, magnetic resonance imaging. Now, a computer then continues the pictures, and MRI produces images, changes its both chemistry and blood flow. So we can easily detect any problem and can really save the person in time, and either suffering from hemorrhage or clot, or before he becomes paralytic, or before he gets a heart stroke, it can be saved. So the computers are doing, that is IT, ICT has brought a lot of technology and service to offer to healthcare sector. Today, our health sector has reached greater heights and taken new leaps and bounds, and able to serve many patients better effectively by integrating IT into their healthcare system, particularly in diagnostic, and for in cancer, in the treatment, we got radiation, we have also got the imaging. These are some of the important applications of the ICT, which are really helping the mankind to overcome the disease and also increase this quality of life. So healthcare definitely has a very positive impact. The ICT has made a positive impact on the healthcare system. But, in education, of course, it has brought a lot of changes and revolution. I'll just go, because of the shortage of time, I'll just read out the important top 10 the applications, global trends in the ICT and education. Mobile learning. Recently, even in the Telangana government, we have launched what is called DISC, Digital Study Kit. So what is this Digital Study Kit? Just it's a study kit of mobile download application, again using IT for platform for learning. So it can be put on mobile. So on mobile, you get all the question paper, subject, summary of each, electricity, magnetism, loss of motion, whatever, chemistry, whatever there, and also number of questions that can be answered. And it also shows how many times this question has come in IIT, and how many times it has come in MCET, how many times it has come in NEET, this question, this chapter. Out of this chapter, which of those are important areas? So analytics is made. And this is done at a mere cost of 350 rupees. They get connected, and the whole thing is downloaded, and it can be, you can do the work offline also, online and offline. So you see, ICT is used for platform for learning. And in my IIIT Basra, we have got what is called NPTEL, National Program for Technology Enhanced Learning. And we are first among the 50 chapters, local chapter that we have. And we are doing well. I've introduced 40-minute lessons in NPTEL. And today, MOOCs, massive online open courses, are going on. And this, again, a revolution in learning, in education system, that we are using every day basis. So today, my students, are able to read. I have given this application free of cost to my 2 lakh students studying in the government colleges. In government college, free education, no fee. About 404 colleges, junior colleges in our Telangana, our Honorable Chief Minister said it should be free education. So free education, not a single rupee is charged. Again, they are getting scholarship, they will get free textbooks, and they are getting the benefit of virtual classrooms, digital classrooms, and now digital study application. So in a way, we are giving IT, taking IT in a big way. And a remotest student in the remotest corner of the state is getting this. Earlier, there is a criticism that IT is only for the urban people. There was a digital divide that only urban people get the access to IT, not the poorest of the poor in the rural area. Today, we have taken a decision to give free connection to all my government college students. Literacy is going to be there, online competition. So the students not only study from the textbook, they should orient to the solving the answers within the time. They should learn the system. So they should start studying online and also answering online. This is what we are going to train them now in the next 1 month and make them very competitive and definitely try to make a very good performance, put up good performance and achieve their dreams to transform into professionals as doctors or engineers. This is again one more initiative we are doing. This is again coming through mobile learning and also IT as a platform for learning apart from increasing the governance. Cloud computing, of course, are increasingly moving up. And there is also one-to-one computing. The trend in classrooms around the world is to provide an information appliance to every learner and create learning environments and assume universal access to the technology. You can access from anywhere, whatever the time, whatever the place, and you can read at your own convenience. That is one-to-one computing. And a net computer, a smartphone is all that you need. So this is again a global trend in the education. Ubiquitous learning. Now what is this? With the emergence of increasingly robust connectivity infrastructure and cheaper computers, school systems around the world are developing the ability to provide learning opportunities to students anytime, anywhere again. And thus, this trend requires a rethinking of the traditional 40-minute lesson. In addition to hardware and internet access, it requires the availability of virtual mentors or teachers and also opportunities of peer-to-peer, self-paced, deeper learning. You can read on your own, you can learn in combination, are under the guidance, under the supervision. Excellent opportunity, and it will take the education one step forward. And gaming, again, has become one of the important things, necessity for our application in our life. So as per the Horizon report found, that massively multiplayer and other online game experience is extremely common among young people, and that the games offer an opportunity for increased social interaction and civic engagement among youth. So how are the youth getting entertained these days? By gamings. And this again, not related to age, it is not age dependent. In fact, everyone is affected or addicted to this gaming. And gaming has become a part of our life. Then there is also called personalized learning, customized learning. Education systems are increasingly investigating the use of technology to better understand a student's address, learning gaps as well as learning style. See, a student is slow paced learner, or a medium pace learner, or a fast learner. So one can adjust the learning as per the pace, customized to the need, and learn accordingly. For example, in a given classroom, if you are going very slow, the medium and the fast paced learners feel restless. And if you are going fast, most of the students become left out because of their slow learning. So we can have what is called personalized learning, going by their performance, by applying some tests. We can grade the students and then give the type of learning to suit their pace and requirement. That is customized learning or personalized learning. And redefinition of learning spaces. Classroom look is going to change very soon. It will not have this board and these chairs. Chairs will not be rectangle, table will not be rectangle. They may be rounded, they may be pleasant. There will be different use of colors to stimulate your mind. Anymore not. The classroom actually evokes a memory of dull response. People get sleepy, people get lethargic, people have a laid down approach. So the classroom should be very intellectually stimulating. Now the very good design of the classrooms are going to change thanks to information communication technology. So it may quickly become this classroom will change as schools around the world. So concepts are use of light, colors, circular tables, individual spaces for students, teacher, and smaller opening spaces for project-based learning are increasingly emphasized. Now the other important thing is teacher-generated open content, and then smart folio assessment, and the teacher-manager mentor. So there are so many new things that are coming up. The teacher-generated open content learning, smart folio assessment, teacher-manager center. So all in all, these are meant to promote learning. Now if you look at some of the important trends, how do you analyze the trend? There can be trend analysis, trend monitoring, trend projection, computer simulation, historical analysis. Why should we study trends? Because generate ideas and identify opportunities. That's why we are studying what is called emerging trends. And identify early warning signals, gain confidence, beat the competition, understand our trend, balance strategic goals, understand the future of specific industries, prepare for the future. Some of the technologies that are potential to be in the future would be digital ink, digital paper, RFID, tele-living, alternative energy sources, autonomic computing. There can be self-healing, there cannot be, need not be repairs, there need not be AMC, CMC. Self-healing computer repair can be done, self-operated, regulated, that kind of autonomic computing will come in the future. And of course, already the supercomputers are there. So finally, I want to conclude by saying that there are so many ethical issues that are there, social ethical issues that we need to address. The growth of the IT and its capability pose a serious threat on the individual's privacy, like surveillance. See, somebody is invading your privacy. You are not alone now. Wherever you are going, CCTVs are following you, scanning you. They are watching you over. Upar wala sab dekh raha hai. So this is again one of the things. So it is good or bad. Today any crime is also immediately detected. If you replay the thing at the road, even on a road when there is an accident, somebody hitting a person and running away, again he can be caught, or somebody doing some criminal engaging in a robbery can be caught thanks to CCTV. So there are very good things. But there is also issue, citizens are saying too much of scan. They are under scan. Wherever you go, biometrics. So wherever you go, you are followed. So and there are CCTVs everywhere when you are going out, and your movements are recorded. So the students, the citizens feel, is it not too much of monitoring and surveillance? And should we not be left to ourselves? Privacy is an issue that we need. We need freedom to be ourselves. Why should we be under scanner? So the communication system, mass storage, retrieval use, constantly being enhanced and improved. So because of this excessive, ubiquitous, universal use of knowledge, we have come out to what is called computer, cyber laws have come out. And now today, we have a cyber law department, and every day, there are so many complaints that are received in terms of the various crimes that are being followed. At the same time, the ICT is useful in detection of crime within the limited time. You would have seen the police today, if a burglary happens, if a robbery happens, if the bank loot happens, within 24 hours they are producing the criminals before the media. That is because of the ICT and the ICT effect. So therefore, while these are very good, but again cyber law is on the increase. Criminals are on the increase. Hacking is going to be much more than it is expected to be. So there needs to be Act of Parliament that relates to Computer Misuse Act. So that is a legal issue. Now data protection. How will you protect your data? How will you save your data? So many people give away data. Somebody calling up and telling you, sir, we are from so many such a bank. What is your name? The people are ready to give even PIN number also. And that is how many wrong things have happened. So in an uninformed society, we need information. We need education to the citizens to protect their data protection, so that the data protection is, personal data is not stolen and hacked and misused for economic purpose, for any other targeting purpose, or even to settle the rivalry in the corporate side and so on. Copyright, design and patent act. Now this is again, everywhere plagiarism is going on. So there is a deliberate, there is also a criminal kind of plagiarism. Taking somebody's work and claiming to be his own, and also patenting it and trying to make money. So these are all need to be safeguarded. We need more patent laws. We need more IPR, copyright, patent laws to be there to protect. This again is a legal issue. So like we said, trends are very good, but again we need laws to check misuse, abuse of this ICT, because it has fallen into the wrong hands, can create a lot of damage and also destruction to the citizens of the society. In the health side also, it is using what is called, it is the ICT is providing health problems. Computer quickly, continuously watching, the eyes are becoming, vision is getting affected, and people are clicking, they are getting what is called carpal tunnel syndrome. So this will be like, while you are kicking so many times, a health problem comes here and it becomes almost like a paralyzed for a period of time. So these health problems are arising to the users. So we need to look at those repetitive strain injury, it is called by the doctors, repetitive RSI. So this kind of thing, and a vision is also affected. Physical safety is also to be looked into. So while it can also do too much of benefit to them, voice recognition, voice synthesis. Voice recognition, voice synthesis is a boon. A blind man can be told, given the messages, the message form can be converted into voice, so that the blind can get to know the messages and understand, because they should be able to follow, while their lives are made better. So in all, there are many ethical issues and also many legal issues, social issues that we need to do. Social media is very quick, responsive, but sometimes it is also irresponsible, not very responsive. That is because there is recently an accident. A young boy of 21 year old met with an accident. He fell on the roadside and the people were watching. And some of them also have taken the covering, video covering, and the people were watching. And some of them also have taken the covering, video covering of the boy who is lying in a pool of blood. For half an hour to 45 minutes, we went on pleading, save me, save me. Nobody has taken him to hospital. People have taken his pictures and posted in the social media. But nobody had at least concern to take that. And some people have gone to the extent of taking selfie with him, but they did not save him. And for want of medical intervention, he died there in that pool of blood. But so many people kept on watching, taking pictures. So social media also should look. There's a diffusion of responsibility, bystander apathy, irresponsibility, and social the social media should take it very sensitively. While we are talking about the selfie or photographs, posting the photograph or the comments, we also should do the social activity. We should not forward the so social media there's a need to act with the social responsibility, not just getting a applause and posting. Why people are doing? Taking too much of risk and taking selfies, posting it, just to get an applause, very good, excellent, as if they have achieved something wonderful. But they are taking a lot of risk. Some people going near the train, getting killed. Some people are going near the water. In Kuntala waterfall, I was a district collector of Adilabad, where now Basar University is also there. So every time, every Sunday, there used to be attract large number of picnic people for on picnic, and invariably there used to be one episode of getting killed. People are going to the edge near the waterfall and want to take a picture and getting slipped and fell down and died. So these are very unfortunate things, all for just posting of that one appreciation from their whoever are near and dear, student, their peer group. They're risking their life. Life is more valuable than selfie. So this should be, social media has promoted certain false sense of values, that even for the, so I just finished my dinner, oh good, excellent, the people are eating. So for small things all of the thing, and if you're going somewhere, happy journey, isn't it? So for everything, the social media has become, information oriented and also compliment oriented, for that compliment people are taking a lot of risk. So the social media should act with responsibility and should be also regulated, because again, you have seen some people were declared dead. Sylvester Stallone was declared dead. Then he wrote, he himself came before the media and said, I'm very much alive. Please don't kill me. I'm doing well. I can live some for some more years. So recently in Telugu film stars also, Srikanth was found to be reported have been met with a serious accident and fatal, and other person like a comedian Venu had died, are suffering from cancer. So this social media, I don't know, to be in the race, that in the information without checking the authenticity. So the one important need we need to take about social media, it should be regulated, because people are posting wrong things about the people, about the celebrities, about the people whom they want to target. There's too much of trolling going on, and also targeting going on, and bringing disgrace, and also doing a lot of damage. Imagine that a person who is alive is told that he posted that condolences to him, died recently. It becomes very, very painful. A person to realize that he's dead. He was declared dead on the social media, even when he's alive. So this is very shocking and disgusting also. So one should give, so social media needs to be YouTube or whatever, all the other media, social media, need, Facebook, need to be regulated, checked, and people should use this with responsibility. So these are some of the emerging trends and issues in information communication technology. Indeed, ICT is a boon to us, and it should be properly regulated and checked. There is one more apprehension, that artificial intelligence is going to bring lot of unemployment, and it will take away some of the traditional employment. There will be paradigm shift in the employment. The human relationship area, human dependent relation area, there is going to be more jobs there rather than in the automation side. So this is one important area that need to be addressed while it is very much learning. So the deep learning, machine learning can replace 50 people at a time, 100 people at a time. What they were doing can be done in 50 minutes. Today, supposing a doctor has to scan about 1,000 MRI scans, can he do it? He may not do it. So the machine can do that faster for him. And can, so for example, I take 100 copies and say, and after scanning 100 copies, only one or two people may have disease, right? So to look at two diseases diagnosed, I should scan, to you study 100. So this is very bad. The machine learning can be taught to see exactly, to hand over that scan which has the disease, which has a disease over it. That way, decision making is quick, the person is able to save, medical intervention is going to be easier. So when AI is going to revolutionize our life, the needs for the its impact, adverse impact also needs to be looked at and plan ahead, because over a period of time, this is inevitable and is going to overtake all our lives. We have to welcome with while we have to welcome with open arms, we also need to regulate it and also address some of the problems that it may cause in the year to come. There should be sufficient planning from today, and I'm sure computer science department has many such will provide answer to the mankind and to the society while welcoming the emerging trends and issue. Once again, thank you very much for welcoming and inviting me here, and also giving me the valuable opportunity. I am by profession, by my academic qualification, I am a medical doctor from Usmania Medical College, MBBS and MD. But I am very much impressed by the computer trends and issues, and I always look up to computer science people as some kind of marvelous scientists and genius, because they are creating so many applications to make the mankind life very much simpler and very much comfort, bringing so much hope and comfort, and also solve day-to-day problems very effectively. So thank you for having such a wonderful topic and having me here. It was a great pleasure and honor to listen to you. Thank you.